For students, having their phone is second nature.
It's gotten to the point where it's just a necessity, you know, you got your keys and your phone and your whatever else you need.
I've left my phone at home before, and when that happens, normally I'm like, oh crap, you know, I gotta go back home or trying to think of ways maybe I can get it back.
Which some students say can actually be more distracted than having your cell phone with you in class, but right now at Pleasant Valley High School, the ability to use your phone changes with each period.
Our school policy has been really, you know, up to the teacher what they want to do in their classroom.
Eric Belby teaches math, and during his class time, he says phones just aren't needed in any way.
Yeah, our job is to teach them, you know, if we like to say, oh, just forget about it, they're not going to learn, that might sound good, but then, you know, with all the policies we have and from the state this year with, you know, not just this year, but all years regarding all students have to learn, no one's left behind, and everyone's going to be held accountable. We can't do that. We got to make sure they're learning.
And while some teachers believe you have to keep a tight leash on cell phones and technology in the classroom, others believe you have to really embrace it in order to reach kids in the 21st century classroom.
Making it no longer forbidden fruit seems to take the joy out of it.
Now, just down the hall from Mr. Belby's math class, the use of a cell phone is encouraged in Mr. Meyer's history room.
What I've seen is that the instances of kids hiding, sneaking it, texting when they're not supposed to, has actually just all but dropped.
And by making cell phones less taboo, Meyer says he has found more ways to use technology and apps in his lessons and day-to-day interactions with students.
It allows kids to text me questions without actually knowing my phone number, or vice versa. I can send out reminders for homework, and if the kids' questions are really good questions, like they don't understand a concept, I can actually forward that question to everybody in the cell, and then other kids will answer the question.
In Bettendorf, Taylor Umland, KWQC, TV6 News.